Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Antoinette Kellier and your mistress of ceremony. I will be your mistress of ceremony this afternoon for Senior Master Sergeant David Roberson's retirement ceremony, commemorating 23 years of honorable service to the United States Air Force. Please stand for the arrival of the official party and the posting of the colors, the singing of the national anthem by special guest, Tech Sergeant Tara Mason, and the invocation also by special guest, Senior Master Sergeant Stanley Scott, both cousins to Robo.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Thank you, Tech Sergeant Mason, for that beautiful rendition of the national anthem. Senior Master Sergeant Stanley Scott will now give the invocation.
I invite you to pray with us as what is customary with your faith. Please bow your heads. Father God, Lord, we thank you for this gathering of friends and family as we commemorate Robo's dedicated service to this country. Father, we know that it's true that a man's heart plans his way, but it is your guidance. It is your sovereign hand that directs his steps. I ask that you just be with Robo and Jay as they open up this next chapter in their life. May it be one of great fulfillment, one of excitement, but most of all, Lord, just have your hand of protection upon them. Have your hand of sovereignty upon them, Lord. We thank you for the many memories that you've given us, and I pray that there'll be more, just even more memories as they continue into this next phase. We thank you and we praise your name. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Sergeant Scott. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. We welcome you and are privileged to share this occasion with several members of Sergeant Roberson's family, Sergeant Roberson's wife, Jay, his mother, Mrs. Jacqueline Roberson, and his sister, Demetrius Carson, his mother-in-law, Ms. Ludella Tate, his sister-in-law, LaDonna Robinson, and her husband, David. Officiating today's ceremony is Lieutenant Colonel John Caranta, Deputy Commander, the 65 Mission Support, Lajes Field, Azores, Portugal. We're also privileged to have with us other distinguished guests, Commander of the Air Force Spectrum Management Office, Colonel David Bosco, and retired Colonel Donald Reese. Welcome. To our other distinguished guests, commanders, chiefs, first sergeants, supervisors, co-workers, and friends, welcome, and thank you for being here today. Recognition of members who are retiring from a career long of honorable service is one of the oldest traditions in the military. Each retiree should leave with a tangible expression of appreciation for his or her contribution to the Air Force. We're here today to do that for Sergeant Roberson. I hope this ceremony will be memorable for each of you, but more importantly, for Sergeant Roberson and his family. We're here today to honor his service and their sacrifices for our nation's defense. It is my honor to introduce today's presiding officer, Lieutenant Colonel John Caranta.
I don't need your script to get my own. Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Robo's retirement ceremony. It's kind of weird for me to hear him called Sergeant Roberson. I worked with him, but I don't know that we ever called him Sergeant Roberson. It was always Robo. So Robo, we're here for you today. Thank you, Sergeant Mason and Sergeant Scott, for the invocation and beautiful rendition of the National Anthem. Beautiful indeed, and a great way to usher out Robo as he moves on. Jay, thank you for inviting me. I'm truly honored to be here with Robo. To do this, it's a great honor. To Miss Jacqueline, thank you for entrusting us for all of these years with your son. The man that stands before us today, actually sitting before us today, is who he is because of you, so thank you for that. To his mother-in-law, to his sister-in-law, family and friends that came in, thank you for coming, some of you very long distances, Alaska, Arizona, Louisiana, all over the country. Thank you for coming. We're here to celebrate Robo. But before we get started, Robo, there's a test. If you pass this test, you get to retire. If not, there's still a couple hours in the day, you gotta get back to the office. Okay, so We're going to play a little game. Okay. When did you enter the Air Force? June 26, 1990. That's not one of the test questions. That was just working our way into it. Okay, June 26th, 1992. What was the number one song in the U.S. in June of 1992? That's number one. We got three questions.
The number one song in 1992?
Yep.
I have no idea.
Anybody want to help him out? Anybody want some guesses?
Somebody help me out with that. Booty and the Blowfish.
Robo didn't know I was doing this, so I'm catching him off guard a little bit. Okay, Robo, I'll give you this one, but you got to get the next two, otherwise it's back to work. The number one song when Robo came in the Air Force was Baby Got Back. I didn't pick the number one. Somebody else did. I'm just reporting it, okay? Okay, Robo. June 1992. We used to do this thing. I don't know if you remember what it was called. Writing letters. Do you remember that? Before all this text messaging and all that junk, all this. Okay. Did you ever write home when you were at basic training?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What was the price of a stamp? What was the price of a stamp in June of 1992?
The price of a stamp?
Mm-hmm. What are we thinking? It was 29 cents. It's not looking good for you, Robo. I guess we should wrap this thing up. We can go home. It's okay. Traffic's okay now. Okay, last one. This one should be easy, but I thought the first two may have been easy too. Give me three pop culture events that happened while you were at basic training. He's gonna say, I don't know. I didn't get to read newspapers, but. That's okay. Tell me three things. That's a newspaper. What are three things that happened in, let's say, June of 92?
Three things that happened in June of 92? Myself and three other fine gentlemen graduated basic training.
Okay, that's one of three. You got two more. It's not quite what I was looking for, but he bombed the first two, so I'll give him that. Two more.
I don't have to.
Okay, that's okay. I guess we'll go ahead and let him retire. A couple other things. The young Elvis stamp beat the old Elvis stamp. That was big news, I think.
Yes.
I don't know. Is it big news? Dan Quayle spelled potato wrong in front of a bunch of students. And Robo, this one's gonna be close to your heart. CDs surpassed the cassette tape as a preferred medium of recorded music. So those are some things. I guess we're gonna let you retire. Is that okay?
Yes, sir, thank you.
Okay. 23 years, 10 bases, 9 different units, 4 major commands, 7 different states, some hot places like Texas, Arizona, Louisiana, the brutal cold of Alaska, right? Congestion and fast pace of this beautiful era we call the NCR. 2 Air Force specialties, vacations in exotic beach-like places in the Middle East. You did some of those. You went to England. You can all read about those things in the bio, and I invite you to take a look at them, but that's not what I'm going to talk about today. I'm not going to talk about what Robo did, more about who Robo is to me and to you, to everybody who got to work with him over the years. If you ask him, what are the major accomplishments of his life, he's going to tell you 4 different things. He's going to say, being married to Jay for 20 years. Robo, you married up. We all know this. He said his second one is surrounding himself with some positive people. His third one is completing his master's degree early in his career. And his fourth is successfully completing a military career. What this tells me is that he's got his priorities right. Every one of us who wears a uniform realizes that one day I got to hang it up. We all have to hang it up. And if your priorities are jacked up, then you're going to be stepping into a situation that's rough. It's a difficult situation. So your 4 priorities are family, friends, education, and career. That's what I'm going to cover today, okay? Is that okay? Robo realized very, very early on that his relationship with his bride was lifelong, and it was very important to him. He needed to feed and maintain that relationship so that when his time with the Air Force was over, she would still be at his side and he at hers. Robo met Jay at Dyess Air Force Base, where they dated for about 6 months. Two of those months, Jay was deployed to Cuba. During this time, Robo found out he was going to England. So on a telephone call, she says, "Hey, Robo, you should marry me and take me to England with you." And so, well, he did one of his few smart decisions in his life, and he married Jay. Jay, thank you for your service to our country, both as an airman and as a spouse. You pushed him when he needed it. You encouraged him throughout his career. You both endured deployments and large, long times of separation. And we all know that Robo is also the man before us because of you. So thank you for that. He would say that his second accomplishment was surrounding himself with positive people that have led to lifelong relationships. In my 10 years of knowing Robo, I found that the opposite was true. He was the positive person that I needed to surround myself with. He was the magnet that everybody was drawn to. Robo always has a smile, listens intently. He always gives great advice, encourages people to succeed. Relationships take two willing participants, and Robo, you are always willing to engage us and build those relationships. So Robo, we're all beneficiaries of your friendship. Thank you. Third accomplishment, master's degree. Robo grew up in a small town, Statesboro, Georgia. At the time, I guess it had about 15,000 people in it at most. It's a college town with a distinct southern style to it. Growing up in a college town is a little interesting. I grew up in a college town. You're around college. You're around the people of college, so it's somewhat familiar. There's cycles to it. Students come, students go. But at the same time, it's a little mysterious and a little distant, almost unreachable, particularly if you came from a family like mine where there wasn't a lot of college graduates. So there's a familiarity, but there's also this foreign sense to it. A bunch of students would come into town, and then they would leave. You saw it, maybe not realize it was something you could be part of. Robo chose to pursue his formal education as soon as he came in. And over the next 15 years, Robo got two associate's degrees, a bachelor's degree, and a master's degree. He juggled his full-time work. He juggled his volunteering, maintaining his marriage, his deployments, and his TDYs. Robo was the first in his family to graduate from college. And he reached that unreachable dream and made it reality. And he encouraged everybody around him to do the same thing. Lastly, Robo lists his military career as a major accomplishment. When we military folks get together, we can look at our uniforms, and I can tell quite a few things about people. It's like an abridged biography. I can tell how long they've been in, maybe where they've been, what do they do for a living. I can tell how much they've accomplished. But it's really scratching the surface. It's not something that you can, you know, I can look at her uniform and I can gauge some things about her, but it doesn't tell me who she is. It doesn't tell me who Robo is. So instead of me telling you some things about Robo's career, I reached out to a few of his prior supervisors and said, "Hey, do you have any funny stories or something you'd like to say about Robo at his retirement?" So bear with me as I quote a few other people. Derek Rogers, where are you at today, Derek? Okay, this is from Derek. Derek and Robo worked together at the 612th Air Communications Squadron in Davis-Monthan, and he relayed this story. You gotta bear with me, Robo, because I may not be able to pull it off very well. While stationed at Davis-Monthan Air Force Base, Robo and I went to BX during lunch and ran into an airman he knew from a previous base. Robo and the young man struck up a normal conversation. However, what was not so normal was the fact that this guy pronounced every word that contained an S with a sh instead. For example, she for see, Cheyenne for saying, wash up for what's up, and shun for sun. This guy didn't have a speech impediment. He thought this was the coolest way of speaking ever. So apparently when they left the BX, they were just cracking up, and from that day forward, every time they talk, they talk like this guy. So show, Robo, next time you see Derek, make sure you say to him, "What's up, Sean?" See what I'm saying there?
Yes.
You okay, Robo?
Yeah.
Okay. Thomas Monin, 608 to ACOMS at Barksdale, says this about Robo. When I think of Robo, my thoughts always go to his sense of humor and extreme good nature. He's always willing to go the extra 2 miles for everyone. Doing the job right every time is not a buzzword for him. It's ingrained in his being. He's an advocate for doing the right thing, an outstanding example for younger airmen, and the consummate professional in his career as a Spectrum manager. Concerning his retirement, the one thing that's difficult to accept is a profound loss the Spectrum management career field will have without him in it. Lieutenant Colonel Dave Hillman, 611th Air Communications Flight at Elmendorf, says this. When we were stationed in Alaska together, I found out he does not like earthquakes. I remember we were all at the office, and after a mild earthquake, from my office, I heard him pick up the phone and call a friend in the lower 48. His voice seemed a bit elevated, and the conversation went something like this. I'm gonna try to do my best Robo impression. Do you know what just happened? An earthquake. That's right, an earthquake. Joe Mingus and Mike Bishop, Stacy Wilkin, also of the same unit, had some serious banter on email regarding a large black panther, a stuffed animal that he had in his office, as well as a plant. The panther seemed to wander around daily, and Robo lovingly took care of that plant. Didn't you even name it?
Chance.
They also seemed to remember that Robo had regular false alarms with the earthquakes. They said he would yell out earthquake even when a truck drove by the building. Now, it's been a while. My recollection of that was Robo would say, did you feel that? And I would say, Robo, you're crazy. We did not just have an... I'm going to check the website. And oddly enough, his feet were like his own sensor, because I never felt him, but he was usually right. Okay. Couple more. Scott Connolly from AvSpace, Comm Support Squad at Pearson, says this. Dave Robeson was one of the most qualified, educated, energetic enlisted men I have ever met in my 35 years in the Air Force. He came to work every day with purpose, direction, and motivation to accomplish the most difficult tasks. Lazy was not in his dictionary.
True.
Sure. That's a true statement, Robo, but none of these are lies. They're at least 10% correct. Colonel Eric Oliver at 24th Air Force says this, Robo was the spark plug of the organization when I was at the 24th. At his retirement ceremony, be sure to tell him that if I were there, I'd bite him on the leg. He'll understand. That's awkward. Most of this is not surprising, what I've brought up today. We've all had the pleasure of working and knowing Robo. I'm not quite sure about that bite comment, though. So I asked Jay, I don't know if you know this, but Jay didn't tell Robo that I was doing this till a couple of days ago. We held it from him. So all of this preparation, Jay, you did a great job on the ceremony. Thank you for this. So all of my intel I had to get through Jay versus Robo. So I asked Jay, what's he going to do? What's he going to do after he retires? She told me he's not going to do anything. She's going to be his sugar mama. However, Robo, I am going to warn you. She also said this. She's going to let you stay home for a minute.
A minute.
But as soon as you bug her, you've got to get a job. I'm going to wrap this up, Robo, okay? I want to be the first person to formally say, sir, thank you for your service to us. Thank you for your many years of service, the many laughs, the great discussions. Thank you for the mentorship and mostly the friendship. The Air Force is a better organization because of you, and many, many people are better off for having you in their lives. May God continue to bless you and Jay in whatever he sets before you. You ready to do this?
Yes.
Let's do it.
It's allergies.
Thank you, Colonel Caranta. A clear testimony of his immense contributions, Sergeant Robo has made. Let's give him a round of applause. We have an Air Force medal to present to Sergeant Roberson today. please stand for the official presentation of the Meritorious Service Medal. Attention to orders. Citation to accompany the award of the Meritorious Service Medal, Second Oak Leaf Cluster. It is awarded to Senior Master Sergeant David R. Roberson for Meritorious Service, 30 September 2013 to 30 June 2015. Senior Master Sergeant David Roberson distinguished himself in the performance of outstanding service to the United States Air Force as Superintendent, Air Force Spectrum Management Office, Air Force Space Command, Fort Meade, Maryland, from 30 September 2013 to 30 June 2015. During this period, Sergeant Roberson led this unique Air Force unit as the senior enlisted advisor to all Spectrum operations personnel. He built a priority placement plan for assignment team to position to the right personnel in the right locations at the right time, enabling national policy objectives, global warfare capabilities, and combat operations all over the world. In addition, he demonstrated exceptional leadership and unmatched management skills by developing the community outreach program to educate and collaborate with every Spectrum manager across 10 major commands. This collaboration directly supports presidentially driven Spectrum reallocation goals and will reap over $633 million from commercial industry. Finally, Sergeant Roberson was the architect of the first ever Spectrum Operations Awards Program, authoring the award criteria, overseeing award solicitation to the field, selecting board members to review the packages, and procuring award hardware to recognize exceptional non-commissioned officers, civilians, and outstanding units across the Air Force Spectrum community. The singularly distinguished accomplishments of Senior Master Sergeant Roberson culminate a distinguished career in the service to his country and reflect great credit upon himself and the Air Force. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the reading of the retirement order. Attention to orders. Department of the Air Force, Headquarters, United States Air Force, Washington, D.C. Special Order Number AC-017082, dated 5 September 2014. Senior Master Sergeant David R. Roberson, effective 30 June 2015, you are relieved from active duty, Air Force Spectrum Management Office, Air Force Command, Fort Meade, Maryland. Retired. Effective 1 July, per AFI 36-3203, in the grade of Senior Master Sergeant. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. At this time, Colonel Carranza will present Sergeant Roberson the certificate of retirement from the Armed Forces of the United States of America, which honors Sergeant Roberson for 23 years of dedicated service. It reads, to all who shall see these presents, greetings. This is to certify that Senior Master Sergeant David Roberson, having served faithfully and honorably, was retired from the United States Air Force on the first day of July, 2015. Signed, General Mark A. Welsh III, Chief of Staff, United States Air Force. Colonel Caranta will now present Sergeant Roberson a certificate of appreciation from the President of the United States, which reads, I extend to you my personal thanks and the sincere appreciation of a grateful nation for your honorable service to our country. You have helped maintain the security of a nation during a critical time in its history with a devotion to duty and a spirit of sacrifice in keeping with the proud traditions of military service. Your commitment and dedication have been an inspiration for those who will follow in your footsteps and for all Americans who join me today in saluting you for a job extremely well done. My best wishes to you for happiness and success in the future. Signed, Barack Obama, Commander in Chief. Colonel Caranta will now present Sergeant Roberson with a montage of certificates of appreciation from the five living United States presidents. President Barack H. Obama, President George W. Bush, President William Bill Clinton, President George H.W. Bush, and President James Jimmy Carter. Caranta will now present Sergeant Roberson with a certificate of appreciation from the Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force, which reads, I am proud to join your friends and family in congratulating you on your retirement from the United States Air Force. The achievements and contributions you have made throughout your career are indicative of the core values of our great service. Your retirement is well deserved, but your selfless contributions will sorely be missed. On behalf of all airmen, thank you for your faithful and devoted service to our nation. As this chapter closes in your life and a new one begins, I hope the years ahead are filled with more great memories and continued success. Signed, James A. Cody, Chief Master Sergeant of the Air Force. Mrs. J. Roberson. Would you please come forward and place the retirement pin on your husband? Thank you. No poking allowed. Thank you. Where would the world's most powerful air and space force be without spouses? Colonel Caranta will present Jay with a certificate of appreciation from the Chief of Staff of the Air Force, which reads, in grateful appreciation, the United States Air Force presents the certificate of recognition to Jay Roberson for the commitment and numerous contribution that have made positive impacts to the nation's defense. Thank you for the support which gave strength and purpose to your husband's service. Signed, Mark A. Welsh III, Chief of Staff, the United States Air Force. Master Sergeant Johnson, please. Oh, thank you. Master Sergeant Johnson will present a certificate from General Dempsey, 18th Chairman, United States Army.
About a good 14 years. He's been my mentor. And I want to say thank you very much. From the bottom of my heart.
Bosco and Sergeant Eiler will come forward to make a presentation on behalf of the men and women of the Air Force Spectrum Management Office.
It's heavy, but I got it. Folks, our hearts are fallen that he has decided to retire. He's been a fantastic force in the Air Force Spectrum Management Office. We want to give him a small token. But we're happy because we know you're going to do great stuff. Best wishes to you and Jay on whatever the next chapter is. So let me read this. It's kind of lengthy here. Obviously, somebody didn't write it well. You'll know this is, again, Seasoned Past Sergeant David R. Roberson, Superintendent, AFSMO. Your enthusiastic touch will be missed at every event. We appreciate your professionalism, leadership, and your efforts to make AFSMO feel like a family away from family. Congratulations on your military retirement and good luck on your future endeavors. The Wizards of the Air Force Spectrum Management Office. Now, before you clap, there's some audience participation I need from you. I'm going to say Wizards, and you're going to say Across the Spectrum as loud as you can. You understand?
Everybody that?
Wizards!
Across the Spectrum!
Thank you, Colonel Bosco, Senior Master Sergeant Eiler. At this time, we have a selection by special guest and Grammy-nominated artist, Carolyn Malachi.
My little brother just finished Air Force basic training, and he's now in school in Biloxi, and I hope at the end of his career he has a reception this wonderful. This is beautiful.
would be a leader. He said I'd never wear a crown. If I wanted to be someone, I should learn to settle down. I tell myself
Thank you, Ms. Malachi. We have, that was really good. Let's do another round of applause. Let's all get it back together. Just before our flag presentation, we've got one more presentation, and it is the shadow box that my profer will attempt to do the Vanna presentation of. And with that shadow box, it houses flags from five different places, flags that have flown over five different places. So there are flags there from that's flown over the US Capitol. There's a flag that's flown over the Pentagon. There's a flag that's been flown over the Alamo. There's a flag that was flown with the Red Tails Unit 376 AEW wing. And there's a flag that's been flown here at the Air Force Memorial. We now have a flag presentation by Senior Airman Mark Formalejo, Senior Airman Cortland Carpenter. Ladies and gentlemen, let's just do one more round of applause. I think we need a minute. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Senior Master Sergeant David R. Roberson, United States Air Force, retired.
First of all, I want to thank, you know, all the commanders, directors, chiefs, chief retirees, superintendents, senior NCOs, contractors, civilians, my family members, special friends, for coming out to this event today. It means a whole lot to me. So first and foremost, I want to make sure that I get that out of the way and let you guys know, because it's not getting out of the way, you need to understand how much this really means to me right now. So thank you, and give every one of you guys a round of applause yourself, please. So we are here, and I gotta let you know, this is not my thing. I'm not a podium guy. You know, typically I get out and I roam around, but I don't understand. Well, you guys may not be able to hear me due to the things that's going on. But the very first thing that I need to do right here and right now is thank my lovely wife of 20 years for putting all this together. I don't know how she did it. Just so you guys may not understand, I absolutely had no idea what to expect here today. It's been a secret the entire time. There was no practice. What you saw was what you saw. And I prefer it that way. I'm usually not the guy to do that, but I prefer it that way because it means a lot to me to see what I'm seeing, and these emotions that you're seeing are real. It's not practiced. And when I saw a lot of the things that went on and a lot of things that had to take place for this to happen today, it makes it all so much special for me to be here with you all. Yes, you've heard many things. I have to thank a good friend, mentor, leader, Colonel Caranta. I had no idea that you were going to do this for me. We go back a long way. And when I finally found out that you were going to do this yesterday, it brought a lot of emotions. And it means a lot to me, only because the only thing that I ever wanted out of this ceremony was to be spread around with family, friends, loved ones, and everyone that means so much to me throughout all these years. By me being in the military, yes, it allowed me to conquer great feats, but I couldn't do that without you and everyone like you. So it means a great deal to even see this happen. I could not have imagined it beyond my wildest dreams. I could not have imagined how this was going to turn out. Now, there's a lot of other people that I need to thank. And it ranges from everyone that actually assisted my wife in putting together this great ceremony for me. So I want to thank, you know, Antoinette. You know I call you Annette in a minute. But Antoinette, thank you for coming here and being the MC. Danielle, thank you for being the proffer. Bruce, everyone around, thank you guys for getting all the accoutrements and everything here. My brother, Kelvin Pontu, thank you, and all of your fine men for putting the events together that you need to do as far as the audio ceremony. Gentlemen, thank you for that fine rendition of that flag ceremony that I just saw here. I greatly appreciate that. And I hope that I am not forgetting anybody, especially my cousin, Stanley, Daz as I call it. Stand up, please. Senior Master Sergeant Stanley Scott, for giving that great invocation that we had. Also, these are family members. Again, remember my first requirement, family friends, to make it very, very special. Ms. Tara Mason, please stand up. Thank you for that lovely rendition of our anthem. I greatly appreciate it. That is also family. That is also a singer. That is also a person that traveled around in the band. And also, were you on the Air Force band as well? Absolutely. So thank you for even traveling this way, bringing your lovely daughter, Lariah, to this area to be here with me today. Lariah, stand up. So without all this, it's many more things that I'm going to have to do. With this being said, I need to take you back with me a little bit. I'm going to take you from the beginning. Did I thank everybody? I'm getting there. Please believe that I am never going to forget that. And I was going to put this in, and that was going to be special. Before I even mention this lovely lady's name, I'm a fan. And I got a great opportunity to go on the Capitol Jazz Cruise. And on that cruise, Miss Carolyn Malachi was one of the performing artists that were there. I did not know until I got here that she was from the DC area. I did not even get the opportunity to get to even meet her until, I'm going to tell these guys' names right now. You guys need to listen. Mr. Bobby Shields, could you please stand up, please, sir? Miss Ebony Shields, could you please stand up? You guys need to know who these people are right here. Their representative, as a matter of fact, Bobby Shields there to standing up. He's the manager of Cayman Kelly, Sirius XM Radio, Heart and Soul, the VIP room. Cayman Kelly, I've listened to him for many, 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 many years. I met those gentlemen on the Capitol Jazz Cruise that we attended. They became instant family members just like that. I need you to know this. Those guys are real, they're genuine, and I love them to death, and they will forever be my brothers, my sisters, here today. And this is what I'm talking about surrounding yourself by positive people, meeting all these people. They did not know me up until last year. And we're family. And I don't know how, please stand up. Stay where you are, Miss Carolyn Malachi. Please stand up. I had no idea that she was gonna be here. You don't understand, I've shed so many tears because I love her to death. I tracked her down, every time I see her hugs. I give her hugs every time I see her. If you do not know her name, Miss Carolyn Malachi, you need to research her because she is that exceptional artist that's out there, as you heard, given that great rendition that I love. You know Miss Mary J. Blige sings that song. You guys know that, right? The song that she sang. And I very, very, am very appreciative of you being here, of you guys being here, and being a member of my family. I will never forget this day. I promise you that. It's so special to me. Thank you. Now, I'm taking you, I'm not going to take you back all these years, but this is what I'm going to tell you. Yes, I traveled a lot, and I met a lot of great people. None of this would be able to happen without my wife's support. Now, baby, I need you to come up. I'm doing this for a reason, but I don't see it. I'm going to have to get it. I need you to come up here in a minute. Somebody please look back. There should be a box, a brown box, on top of my deal back there. It's a little brown box full of packaging. Yes, please bring that. Nope, not that one. It's a brown box that was packaged. Should have been brought in here. Meanwhile, while that's going on, you guys look at me, I'm gonna keep talking. So, this woman of 20 years has made me the man that I am today. I love her with all of my heart. You need to understand that. I could be nothing without her pushing me on a regular basis to be the better man that I am. It could not happen without her love and her support. So, what can you give somebody who already has it all? I can't. You guys know we don't really, my wife doesn't do flowers or anything like that. She doesn't really necessarily like flowers, right? So it's very, very hard for me to determine exactly what it is that she likes. And I could never, ever repay her for any of the things that she's done for me over all these years. But this is what I'll tell you about my wife. My wife has been a connoisseur of many, 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 many Gucci items. So, long and hard, she's been eyeballing this specific thing. Come on up here, baby. So, she's been eyeballing this specific item for a while. It actually has been brought back on several occasions. It's a special watch that Gucci makes, and I need to be able to present this to her today so you guys understand how much I love her. So you won't be able to see this watch from back there, but this is the Gucci twirl watch that she's been looking for many, many, many years. I got it upside down and it still has a tag on it, so you know what's going on.
Gucci. All right, baby. Thank you. Love you too. Gucci.
So I could not do that without her support. That's just a small memento that I can give her to let her know how much I truly, truly love her. So that is one of the very, very strong women that's in my family. Several of them that exist. I got a little emotional when I presented my mom the flag. I got emotional for a reason. You see, that's my heart. And I tried to do my best to make her proud of me. That's all I ever wanted to do, both her and my father. My father couldn't make it here today. His name is David Roberson as well. But he understands how much I love him as well. They gave me every tool that I needed in order to be successful, to come and be a kind, responsible person. My dad always told me, be a man of your word. That's all you have. That is our name. So if anybody asks the question, it should be revealed as it's the same throughout, no matter who's there, no matter who hears it. You understand if I tell you I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it. If I tell you, regardless of what the situation is, I love each and every person that I've ever come across, okay? You guys need to understand that. It's not something that I fake. It's genuine, because that's all I know how to be. But that couldn't have been developed without that strong foundation. that I have. So on behalf of my father, and I need to back up a little bit, my grandmother, Betty Scott, my grandfather, who passed away recently, Buster Robertson, they were very, very instrumental. They were very key in my development with my mom and my dad. So, on behalf of all of them, I want my mother to come up here, my very beautiful mother, to please come to the podium. On behalf of the entire family living and those that have gone on to that greater place, please come up. You guys need to understand, when I tell you this is my heart, this is my soul, this is what it is. For those of you who need to understand who have moms, who have fathers, you need to tell them every day how much you love them, how much they mean to you. Because we don't get the opportunity to do that a lot. And before you know it, sometimes that time passes. And I don't want that time to pass. This woman standing to my left is everything that I am. And I love her so much. And so, Antoinette, please. So, mother, you guys, she and I both love purple, okay? I don't do regular flowers anymore. My wife taught me that. Why go out and spend all that money when you're just gonna die on you, and then what does it mean? What does it really, really mean? Why are you spending $190 on an arrangement that's gonna die tomorrow? When you can buy me, put something on a Gucci. So, what this is an arrangement, and I need to also let you know that my wife made every one of these arrangements here today. It's purple roses, they're made of wood. They're made of wood for a reason, because wood lasts. And my mother's love has lasted my entire lifetime. I want to be able to give her this so she can look at it daily and understand how much she means to her son. Please, everyone, give my mom a round of applause.
You ask them to buy the black bag with the purple and the mask up to present it.
Right now? You want to do it right now? Okay, guys, we're going to make an audible. It's an audible to this. I understand that there's a black bag that's somewhere with purple in it. My mom would like to do something with that black bag. Where is that black bag located? We're going to do this so everybody, this is a scavenger hunt. First person to be able to find that black bag with purple in it can have the Gucci tag off my wife's watch. Is it that one? So. So you want to say something?
Yes.
Okay.
I am so proud of my loving son, him. His father couldn't be here today, but I'm in the place when you're married, you become one. You speak for one another when the other cannot make it. We are proud of our son. We are proud of our daughter that's sitting right there. They have never, ever put any heartache on our heart. When you speak up, do you know where your kids are? We can say, yes, we do. And I just want to give him something to remember from his parents. And I'm presenting it to him today. son, I know you love black, purple, and gold. I had this made up for you. So when you look at this, you know that your mom and dad love you always, always. So here is your plaque, and we love you, and you can do what you want. And that's your card that is in that plaque over there.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. You're going to take it back. You got it? You okay? So, guys, again, that's number two, right? That's number two, strong woman that I've been privileged to be around. There's another. That is my mother. I also have a mother-in-law that you guys need to understand who accepted me into the family with open arms. She's loved me like no other person. She's very, very, very special to me because of the person that she is. Miss Ludella Tate, could you please come up for a second, please? Please, I need you to come up here too, as well. Because a family is a family, is a family. That's everyone, right? She's beautiful too, isn't she? Just like my mom. I got some gorgeous mother-in-law, my mother-in-law and my mom, right? You know it.
True.
True. So, I want to thank you for over these 20 years of treating me as if I was your son. And when I say that, you guys need to understand, a lot of times, mother-in-laws get a bad rap. True. True. Not this one. She's treated me kind. She's treated me with understanding, and I have a gift for her as well. Mm-hmm. Also made by Miss J. Roberson. So remember what I told you the concept here is. We don't give things that's gonna die and perish the next day, right? I don't know if this is her favorite color, but it's kind of pretty, huh?
It's beautiful. Beautiful.
So, these are also wooden roses. I want her to think about this day as well and let her know that I'm very, very appreciative of her as well and for everything and allowing me into this family. So, brother, I love you.
I love you, too. Thank you.
Up to me. Now, guys, I'm not going to stay up here. Oh, thank you. Thanks. See, that's what I'm talking about. That's a wingman. That's a wingman right there. So I'm not going to run through a whole lot of years, but this is what I'm going to tell you. We're going to do this real, real quickly, okay? We're going to do this real quickly because you guys need to be acknowledged as well, all right? So you met the family when I came in. You met the people that actually developed me. Prior to that, once I enlisted, I had to go to basic training, right? In basic training, you have special people that are out there in basic training. Only one of those fine gentlemen could not be here today. My brothers from basic training, Master Sergeant Kelvin Pontu and Senior Master Sergeant Jason Payne, please stand up. So from development, what you see is those are my brothers. We came into the military together the exact same day. We will always be bonded by that date. The only person that could not be here is a part of the alphabet crew. One of them alphabet boys, FBI, CIA, you know, whatever. He could not be here. He's doing some other things that allowed him not to be able to do here. His name is Mr. Bryant Rogers. We all came in together, right? We left there once we graduated. Quickly, very quickly, the very first place that I went to was Dyess Air Force Base, as you ran that down. At Dyess Air Force Base, Abilene, Texas, is where I met my lovely wife. You've already met her. Is there anyone else in here from Dyess Air Force Base? Stand up. Bam. Bam and bam. lift the mic up. She's telling me I'm bending down. So what you see there is you see those five guys who's been with me from Dyess Air Force Base, which is my first duty station. That's where I met them. They stood up. That's Mr. Tony Granger and his lovely wife, Terry Granger, sitting right next to him over there. You already met my cousin. They stood up. I love you guys deeply. Can you hear me good? Everybody's kind of squinting. Okay. So after I left Abilene, Texas, the very next place that you heard it I went to, which is where I had to propose to my wife and take her along with me, was RAF Mildenhall in England. In RAF Mildenhall in England, is there anybody in here from RAF Mildenhall in England that was there with me? You're going to see probably some of the same people stand up, but stand up anyway so you can see how this trend goes. RAF Mildenhall up in England. That's my cousin Stanley Scott, who's been following me quite a bit. And you will also see Calvin Pontu, who was also over in Croughton. Okay? So after we left RAF Mildenhall, I actually went to, where did I go to after RAF Mildenhall? That was Dyess Air Force Base in Texas. Sorry, I said Dyess again. Davis Monthan, one of those D's. You understand what I'm saying? Stay with me. So Davis Monthan in Arizona. There, who do I have in here from Davis Monthan? You should see a person arrive, that basically a few people. You see Mr. Derek Rogers, who's sitting there dapper. That was my first supervisor. And you also see lovely stand-up Daryl and Vaughn. They're very, very, very good family members and friends, right? After we left Davis Monthan, where did we go? We actually went to Barksdale Air Force Base in Shreveport, Louisiana. Barksdale, please stand up. See those lovely individuals all there? Sharon, Major Williams, Brenda, and Damon Hall, and Sean Sunseth in the back, right? Right? See where we're going with that. And who else did I miss? And also, love you, Sharon. Love you. I love you. I apologize. I love you. After we left there, Sharon, we actually went to Elmendorf Air Force Base, Alaska. Who do I have from Elmond Air Force Base, Alaska? Please stand up. Please stand up. Please stand up. You see them again, Miss Tony and Terry Granger. You'll see my Mr. Caranta, Colonel Caranta, and you'll see Alfreda Tyler. And also Sean Sunsets, Fish On. Fish on, fish on, fish on. David Williams is not standing up, but he knows that he was out there in Alaska with me, and he's here today. You know, I call you out. You stand up, stand up. After we left there, I went to Peterson Air Force Base, Colorado. Stand up. Boom, Bruce Sora, Peterson Air Force Base. Who else I have? Boom, you got my man. There, boom, that's family members. That's family, Jamie, family members that's there. You see where I'm going with this? Everybody always follows each other around. After I left there, where do we go? Where do we go after that? What are we on? I went to San Antonio, Texas. Who do I have from San Antonio, Texas? I know I have a few people. David Williams is back in San Antonio, Texas right now as we speak, okay? Left San Antonio, Texas, and I came to the beautiful DMV. The DMV here, D.C., Maryland, Virginia. Who do I have that's everybody stand up? D.C., Maryland, Virginia. DMV. Everybody in here. See, this is what I'm talking about, the transition that we have had from all the family members, all the friends that I met. Bobby, Cayman, and all of them couldn't be here. I love Cayman Kelly to death. You guys make sure that you know and you tell him that. As soon as I see him, I love him. That's my brother, Sirius XM Radio. Guys, this has been a fantastic event. I'm very, very excited and very happy to be Mr. Roberson now. You know? So thank you again for spending your day with me in this very surprising, impromptu session for me to be here and to be overwhelmingly surprised about everything that's here. I thank you, and I will see you here in a few minutes to do a few things. Good? Thank you very much.
We extend, please be seated. We again extend our congratulations to Sergeant Roberson and his family, Mr. Roberson. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the playing of the Air Force song and the departure of the official party. Gentlemen, this concludes our ceremony. On behalf of our newest retiree and his family, thank you for attending today's ceremony.